You're watching Cannabis Planet with your hosts, Ungayo Bilam and Sarah Diesel. We bring you news and information, collective profiles, growing tips with Ed Rosenthal, cannabis cooking, entertainment, and more. Cannabis Planet, a gift from the galaxy.
Welcome to Cannabis Planet. I'm your co-host, Ungayo Bilam, and I'm joined by the multi-talented and lovely Sarah Diesel. Hello, Sarah Diesel.
Hello, Ungayo.
How's it going?
It's fabulous to be here. Tonight, we have a great show for you. We will take you out to the Purple Haze Music Festival, and we're going to take a look at our poignant senior citizen patient testimonial.
We also have some cannabis cooking tips, and our man, Ed Rosenthal, will be here with his weekly growing tips, and we got all kind of other good stuff. Each week, we have been showing you that cannabis can be used as a very effective medicine. Well, cannabis is also a very powerful industrial tool in the form of hemp. Let's have a look at this next segment.
A sawmiller's daughter, Patsy Harmsen, also looks to hemp as a viable substitute for trees in papermaking. She sees it as a potential savior of Tasmania's fast disappearing old growth forests.
When Dad went into the bush to get saw logs, everything was left intact. You couldn't tell where they'd been to get the logs, and the undergrowth thrived and the animals thrived and there was very little disturbance. So the love of the forests was a very, very important starting point for me. And the next one was outrage when I realised that in fact wood wasn't the best material for making paper. It's certainly been turned into wonderful paper by people who've poured heaps of energy and heaps of chemicals into it, but it is not a natural fibre for paper. And the best natural fibres are, in fact, annual farm crops, like, and especially hemp and flax as well. I can't believe that anyone could ban a plant that's absolutely natural and wonderful and put here for everyone to use with thousands of users.
With the harvest of their third experimental crop, Patsy is determined to prove hemp can be used as a replacement fibre in Tasmania's massive pulp industry. Part of this crop is earmarked for the research laboratories of Australian Newsprint Mills, Australia's largest supplier of newsprint paper. ANM consumes over 500,000 tons of trees every year, but that's only a fraction of the 9 million tons felled in Australia annually for pulp and wood chips. In fact, the timber in this yard is only enough to fill Australia's newsprint needs for one day. With the controversy surrounding the logging of old growth forests, ANM has recently moved to plantations for its fibre input. But pine and eucalypt pulps need a stronger fibre to reinforce them, and the company spends $20 million each year importing bales of craft pulp made from spruce trees.
This particular one's come from...
Len Johnson, ANM's technical manager, believes locally grown hemp may have the potential to replace this expensive import.
Fibres showing up here. Now, you have to add that to newsprint to make it strong enough to handle. Obviously, hemp can contribute to this sort of strength, although it would require some pretty special treatment, some special equipment. You know, it doesn't come cheap.
Well, originally we wanted to see hemp being able to replace all grades of paper, but really we have to be realistic, so we were wondering if it could start off an industry perhaps by replacing this very expensive craft softwood pulp because of its extremely long fibre and strength characteristics.
Believe me, it is possible, and this sort of material can be made, a material somewhat like this can be made from hemp, and it can be added to our pulp, and it would be an asset. And it would be an asset to Tasmania too, by the way, wouldn't it?
It would be
a great boom.
Nug Magazine, San Diego's original cannabis publication. Always free of charge or subscribe at www.nugmag.com.
Hi, my name is Bo. I'm 79 years old. father of four sons, and grandfather and great-grandfather to 27 others. I'm a musician, a former United States Marine veteran, and last year I had an operation leaving me with a hernia that left a great discomfort. My grandson said, "Grandpa, why don't you apply for medical marijuana to help ease the pain?" Well, I never thought that I would, but guess what? I did, and it works for me. The few, the proud, the Marines.
Medican, a prescription for change.
Downtown Kushtown's Cooperative.
We're conveniently located in downtown San Diego.
Steps outside of the gas lamp.
Killer meds, tons of choices.
These guys get it. Downtown Kush Lounge Cooperative.
Green Cross Cooperative. Steps from the Sand on Mission Boulevard, the Beach City's premier in quality, selection, and pricing. With plenty of additional parking, two blocks north off El Carmel on Mission Bay.
Medical cannabis has become the leading alternative in healthcare for many Californians. Here at MC Square, we show that we care by offering the lowest cost recommendations, knowledgeable staff to answer your questions, a compassionate doctor, and a convenient location.
Brought to you in part by Advanced Nutrients.
The Purple Haze Music Festival was held this past July 18th and was billed as California's largest pro-marijuana music festival.
This was a hot event, literally and figuratively. It was a day filled with fun, cannabis culture, a ton of music, and of course, munchies. But by the daytime, the temperatures were sweltering triple digits. I'm getting hot just thinking about it, Ingaio.
Yeah, you are. Our field reporter, Dragonfly De La Luz, was there taking it all in, and I'm pretty sure she even ran into Jack Harrah at this gig. So let's go out to the Inland Empire and see what she has to say.
Thanks, Sarah and Ingaio. We're at the Purple Haze Music Festival in San Bernardino County, and it's a pro-marijuana festival. People are getting medicated everywhere. There's booths, there's live music. We just got here. The sun is high, it's like 110 degrees, and we're getting elevated too. So let's see what's at this party.
A new West Coast, Southern Cali, where we're living.
Going through a difficult time.
While the green grows up in the back, I'm rhyming in the kitchen.
Right, my life story, you're wrong.
Get some nice flow just by looking out the window.
Can I kiss my?
With some sunshine on the South West Coast, Cali.
I believe that from the events like this, we have to legalize cannabis 100%. President Nixon and Ford said we will outlaw cannabis 100% and we'll give it all to the pharmaceuticals. 36 million Americans have died from cancer.
Large doses of THC in the laboratory rats killed every cancer under the sun, and they lived longer than the rats that never had anything at all.
And those rats lived longer, and they were healthier. Instead of 9 to 18 days a day, they lived 8 to 9 months. And the average rat only lived 7 months.
Wow, that's quite some evidence in favor of legalization.
Well, you can think so.
We have brownies, chunk chocolate, peanut butter, snickerdoodles.
We're talking to Charlie Larson, who's president of Medical Marijuana, Inc. Tell us about your company.
Well, we're the first public company to service the medical marijuana industry, and we hope to bridge the gap between public officials, law enforcement, and the operators in the industry, and bring it out into the open and show everybody that it's a legal and compliant industry that can help save our economy and add tax dollars to the economy, create new jobs, boost small business growth. And we hope to just facilitate the all the operators of the industry in any way we can.
Feeling, you know, to uplift people through our music. I mean, we always have, always will play for the people. You know, as long as they're willing to listen to us and listen to our word and have a good time. And if it does something for you, I mean, that's even better. I mean, that's what we want.
That was the Purple Haze Music Festival. This is Dragonfly. Thanks for watching Cannabis Planet Television.
I'm Don Bowles, and I'm watching you watching Cannabis Planet.
I certainly didn't think that I was the type of person to use marijuana as medicine until I did, and I realized that marijuana works.
Medican, a prescription for change.
Victory 215 provides safe access to medical cannabis. Discounts for seniors, veterans, and college students. Located at 1025 West Lower Street in San Diego.
The World Cannabis Championship Cup is coming to L.A. April 24th, and you're invited. Witness medical marijuana history as celebrity judges crown the world's best indica, sativa, and hybrid grower champions. The World Cannabis Championship Cup, April 24th in L.A. This event will sell out.
Advanced Nutrients has the products you need for healthy gardens, bigger buds, and greater yields. Scorpion juice, iguana juice, Synthezyme, organic bee, colossal bud blast, and big bud. AdvancedNutrients.com.
Welcome back. The retirement community of Leisure World in the conservative Orange County community of Laguna Woods Village recently opened a medical marijuana collective, the Laguna Woods for Medical Cannabis Collective. Now, this collective is technically outside the gates of Leisure World, yet most of the collective members are indeed Leisure World residents. Dr. Bill Schweed is one of the organizers of the Laguna Woods Collective, and he's 88 years old. We recently visited with Dr. Schweed out at Leisure World in Laguna Woods, and let's hear what he had to say.
My name is William Schweed. I'm an MD. I have a master's degree in public health. I've been a physician since 1944 when I graduated medical school. I did the service. I contracted poliomyelitis in the service in 1947. I got better within a year or two and went to work, and I haven't used a cane until about 10 years ago when post-polio affected me. As a physician for 60 years, I realized that our aging population is in great medical need and not adequately satisfied by the conventional medical profession. And so we thought that cannabis might be helpful for them. And I've read on this subject for many years, and the research is extensive and stunning and is sound, and more research is necessary. However, the federal government has declared it illegal to even possess it and incarcerates people cruelly and unjustifiably. Causes of death: alcohol, heroin, dilaudid, morphine. Causes of death. Causes of death from marijuana: zero. There are no causes of death from marijuana. I feel that the role of cannabis plays a role in national health care reform because it allows the citizens to take over and determine what's good for them. And the American citizens are for health care reform, but the pharmaceutical companies and the insurance companies oppose it and spend millions to oppose it. We want help in growing. We want help in people teaching each other how to use it and how to use it effectively. It allows people to express how they feel about their medication, about the management of their care, and patient input is very important. And I've always encouraged my patients to help me, help them take care of their problems.
My name is Paul Armentano, and you are watching Cannabis Planet, a gift from the galaxy.